Hi, I'm Jade from Jobber. Let's talk about the Jobber app, how to navigate through the app, and what's on each tab. When you first open the app, if you're an admin user, you will see Home. This is an overview of everything going on in your Jobber account. At the top of Home, there is a bar that shows the progress of your team's appointments for the day, including appointments that are still to go, completed, and active. Tap the bar to see each of today's appointments in more detail, sorted by the team members they are assigned to. Home also shows the progress of your request, quotes, jobs, and invoices, and highlights some of the key statuses for each of these items so that you can take action on them and keep your workflow moving along. Tap the bell icon in the top right to view activity feed, where you can see a stream of what your team has been up to. Tap the plus icon in the bottom right. This is the quick create menu. This icon appears all throughout the Jobber app so you can create new work. Next, we have the schedule tab. This is where you can view your schedule with different schedule views. Tap the View Options icon to switch between different views. There's a day view, where you'll see one day at a time, and items on the schedule are blocked off based on their duration with any time visits at the top. A list view, where schedule items appear as cards in a list. The cards are ordered by time with the scheduled items at the top and any time visits below. A 3-day view, where you can see 3 days worth of the schedule at a time. Items on the schedule are blocked off based on duration with any time visits at the top. A week view, where you can see the full week with columns for each day of the week. And a map view, where your appointments for the day are displayed geographically on a map. If you have permissions that allow you to use team view, you can see other colleagues' schedules by adding additional team members to the list view or the day view. To switch between different dates, use the week selector at the top of the app or tap the month to navigate to a different date. Next, we have the timesheet tab. This is where you can clock in and out for the day and view your log time. Each card represents a timesheet where you can see the time the timer was started, the timer duration, and if it was a general or visit timer. Next, we have the search tab. This is where you'll see a list of your clients sorted by those who have been recently active. To narrow down the list, use the search bar at the top or tap specific work items to filter that item by type. The client list shows the status of these items so you can see at a quick glance the progress of each item. Next, if you're using two-way text messaging, you have the messages tab. If you sent your client a quote or an invoice as a text message or text them anything else through Jobber, you'll see those conversations here. Tap into each conversation to continue texting back and forth with that client, or tap the compose icon to start a new message. Last but not least, we have the gear icon for your account settings. This is where you'll go to sign in and out of the app, manage your app settings, and get support from Jobber.
Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, be sure to check out the Help Center as well as our other videos.